All right, good day to everyone. This is your professor, Dr. AP, and we are in our subject CEA5, numerical solutions for CE problems. Okay, so minasan, konnichiwa. Okay, let's go immediately to our slide. As you can see, so let us start with a guiding philosophy. Okay, this is more on the philosophy of learning rather than our specific topic today. If you don't let a teacher know at what level you are by asking a question or revealing your ignorance, you will not learn or grow. Okay. The reason why the teacher are asking your feedback is to for us to gauge your knowledge on the topic. What are the things that we still need to inculcate into your minds? Okay, so that is a feedback mechanism. That's why we want you to ask questions. We want you to give comment. If you are, for whatever reason, silent all of the time, how can we know? How can we know your level of understanding? How can we know your level of understanding? It is impossible to guess your level of understanding, particularly we have so many students. Okay? So please participate so that we can expound on particular example or part of the explanation. So it depends. Okay. And again, you can pretend for long, for you will eventually be found out. For example, we have actual cases here. Somebody was able to enter, for example, a university or a school, for example, science high school, because of not a valid merit, but for example, by political consideration, okay? So was able to enter a particular good school. But eventually, later on, it will be found out that there is something wrong. Okay? He or she did not really learn from this school. Okay? That is a trend nowadays, particularly election time. There is a one viral issue that some candidates was lying about his graduation or getting of the bachelor's degree from a certain university. Okay. So everybody will later on found out. Okay, so you can avoid being caught today, but tomorrow. So the important thing is be yourself and be proud of what you can. No need to look like a fool or look like an intelligent person when you are not. But just be yourself. Just be ourselves. Okay? Because being ourselves, there is no pressure. And if there is no pressure, our mind will work better and we can learn more. Okay? So there are so many pressure going around in our environment. So it's very hard to learn. 100% must be focused on our learning, particularly you are on your starting point. Okay? So a while ago, I told you that third year is actually the starting point of your engineering career, because first year, second year are more on mathematics. So this subject in particular is actually not 100% mathematics. It is a mathematics in classification, but actually this subject is now going to engineering side. No? From mathematics, we are now transitioning into engineering problems. Okay? To give you an information, what we learn, they are important. What we learn in first year, second year, they are important, but they cannot solve 95% of the problem. 95% of the problem will be solved by this subject. Okay. All right. That is how important this subject is. Okay. The concept of this subject, the methods of this subject will be used in your major subjects, even in design. Okay. So your future career will depend on your understanding of this subject. This is the starting point. This is the basic. This is basic, but this is the starting point. Without this, how can you propose a practical, feasible solution in the future? Okay. So, because mathematics cannot do it in real world. Okay. That is the difference of mathematician and engineering. Of engineers, no? So we engineers are solving problems in real world. Okay, so mathematicians are solving problems, harder problem maybe, but they are solving problems theoretically. Okay, theoretically. Okay, so let us continue. So. Therefore, the question is, why we have to use numerical solution? Okay. Okay. What are the aspects of our profession that we need to use numerical solution or numerical method? Okay. So I already told you my own guess, no? I guess 95% of the problem will be solved by numerical. Okay? Numerical solution as used in your different major subject. For example, structural, design, okay? So transportation. So we can use numerical solution. Okay? To solve problems that cannot be solved exactly. There are problems that cannot have exact solution. What do we mean by exact solution? Those problems that have exact solution are solvable by those mathematics courses that you took on your 2 years in engineering. First year and second year in engineering. Those are exact solutions. Okay? All of the problems that you learn from the first 2 years of engineering can be solved by exact solution. Okay? And being exact, totally accurate, 100% accurate, that is on the realm of mathematics. Okay? That is on the realm of mathematics. Okay? Sir, because of that, sir, mathematicians are better than engineer. Of course, there are many times that they are better than engineers. But again, engineers are solving problems in real world. Okay. Okay. Let's continue. If you can take a look at the figure below, you have what? This is an integral solution. No? This is an integral solution. And actually, this integral equation is what we call the normal distribution curve. Okay. This equation that you see is the normal distribution curve. Okay. And specifically, as you can see on the graph, we have what? Standard deviation, mean. So those are what? Those are statistic terminology. Okay. Those are terminologies from statistic. Okay. So probability distribution function versus the quantitative value, wherein we can see the mean. Okay. Mean is 20. The other term for mean is average. Okay. Another term for mean, average. So we have an average of 20. You can see on the curve that 20 has the highest. It's the highest portion of the curve. Okay. So as you can see. So standard deviation 3.5. Okay. Although it's not shown in the curve itself, we know what do we mean by standard deviation. Does everybody already have statistics? For example, let us call Vergara. Did you already pass the statistic, Vergara? Vergara is not listening. Montes, you already have statistic.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Is that a second year subject or third year subject?
Second year po.
Okay, so good. I am asking because take note your you are now in the K to 12 level, no? And you have what? New curriculum in engineering. So we have a different curriculum from you, no? So I think we took statistics in our time during our third year, no? So because you only have 4 years in engineering for the moment, so you have to take your statistic during second year. So because of that, you are familiar with this curve and you are familiar with this equation. Take note, it is not my responsibility to review the previous mathematics, okay? It is my responsibility to teach you and prepare you for this subject, numerical solution, not in the previous subject. Okay? You have to what? To review the prerequisite subject, all the mathematics at your own time. Okay? Because just like what I've said a while ago, I am assuming that you already mastered all of the other mathematics before you take the subject. Okay? Because the subject transitions from mathematics to engineering. That is what is this subject all about. We transition from pure mathematics into a type of mathematics that is used in engineering. This is the type of mathematics that is used in real world. Okay? Okay? So, let us continue. We are using numerical solution to solve problems that are intractable. Okay? That are intractable. For example, as you can see, this is an example of structure. Okay? What you can see in the picture is an example of structure. Again, I will call somebody. To ask. I would like to ask somebody. Alaysa.
Yes, please, sir.
Alaysa, are your class taking structural theory this semester?
Yes, po, sir, with Mansotero po.
Come again, please louder.
Yes, po, sir. We have structural theory with Engineer Sotero po.
Ah, structural theory. Okay. So you have structural theory subject this semester. Okay.
Yes, okay. Please, sir.
So what will you study is, for example, this structure. This is a structure. And that is very important in engineering because we are the type of engineers who are authorized to design and put up a structure which are safe. Okay? Okay, which are safe. Not just putting up the structure and what not. Just pray to God that the structure will not fall. No, we have to design it, prepare, plan, so that the structure have the minimum requirement, minimum capability, based on standard, based on code, based on law, acceptable to the type of risk that the community expect. So, to solve problems that are intractable, therefore, meaning there are structures that are more complicated than others. There are structures that are very simple. And of course, you are just learning your structural theory now. You will start with basic and simple structure. Very basic structure. There are two columns and one beam. So maybe that is the starting point of your learning. But as you can see in this figure, this is not a basic structure. Okay? This structure is small. As you can see, this is small. But it is by no means simple. It is by no means basic. It is a very complicated structure. For example, if you can see, Alaysa, can you see my arrow? Can you see? Yes, okay. Everybody, please look at my pointer. Okay. For example, I will ask you. You are learning structural theory. If I ask you now, I will put 1 kilogram load in this portion, and I will ask you, from that one kilogram that I will put here in this specific area, my question is, what is the reaction of this area, of this portion? What is the reaction from that 1 kilogram? Load. Okay? And if you ask that, I hope you will not ask that in your structural theory, because you are just having basic learning of structural design. No? Try to ask that in other civil engineers with, for example, 30 years experience in the field. It cannot be answered right away. There is a very complicated computation that will take place before somebody, even an experienced expert, to be able to answer this. Okay? Just how complicated this type of structure. What more if we have in the real life? This is structure is just a what? It's just a sample laboratory scale. Example of structure. What more in real life? For example, 33. We have 35-story building in BGC. By far, the highest building in the Philippines is in BGC. Okay. Okay. So, how complicated is that? Okay. A team of engineers, not a single engineer. A team of engineers with so many engineering tools. Okay, using what? Numerical solution. Because it is almost impossible now, although those engineers know how to do it, but physically impossible or impractical to do it. Okay, to solve this using exact solution. Okay, using exact solution. So, if you are using structural theory, maybe you will use what? Integral calculus, you will use differential calculus. Okay? It is almost impossible. Okay? To find how much is the loading reaction of this part from the 1 kilogram load that I put on this upper portion. Almost impossible. Okay? Okay? So, that is why we are going to use numerical methods. Okay? In order to what? To give an answer immediately. To give an answer, by the way, immediately meaning by use of tools, by use of engineering softwares. Okay? Okay? By use of engineering. But during our course of one semester discussion, maybe we will use application softwares during our what laboratory time. But in our lecture, we will what do the what manual problem solving, just to learn, just to get your system into the power of numerical solution. Okay? Just to get an experience. No? And later on, in your job, you will not do it manually. Okay? You will not do it manually later on in your career, in actual. No one is doing it in actual problem solving. No one is doing it manually because we are just learning. We want you to know the concept at the very basic level, at the very bottom. After we know it, then we can now start to use application softwares. Okay. That is why you can expect after the end of this subject, you can answer the question with engineering judgment. Okay? While encountering what practical problems. Okay? So that's why this subject is important. Okay? How do we solve an engineering problem? We know that already in other engineering subject, we already know that problem solving, we need to know the requirement. The requirement meaning what we are asked for. And to know what you are asked for, what the problem is asking you to do, you should be able to describe the problem first. Okay? If you can describe the problem, therefore maybe you can model it. Okay, so problem description is coming out from the real world. You describe it in order to solve the problem into your laboratory. For example, think of yourself as a scientist. Think of yourself as a scientist. Okay? You go outside to the field and take a sample of something and bring that sample inside your laboratory and what? Observe your sample in the laboratory. Okay? So, in the same manner, engineers do it all of the time. All the time. We have to look at the requirements, describe the problem, and the problem have to be represented by a model, mathematical model. Okay? Okay? And usually, in your first year and second year of engineering learning, the mathematical model that we are talking about here is actually the equation. The mathematical equation. Okay? So that is what we mean by mathematical model here. But later on, we will know that the equation can be transformed into a slightly different form, what I call the engineering form of equation. Okay? Take note, I am distinguishing what is mathematics from engineering. Okay? So, mathematics is totally different from engineering, as you will see in this course. Okay? So, in this course, we will use an engineering model, which is also an equation, but slightly a different form of equation. And after that, of course, we will try to solve that equation. Okay? As we are always doing it in our algebra, trigonometry, geometry, calculus, whatever mathematics subject, we are doing this. But in those areas, we are always using a mathematics model that have exact solution. Take note, exact solution. Okay? Now, you can solve that equation and have also an exact result. And after which, in order for us to be a really engineering discipline, we have to use that solution. In our first year, second year, we stop at solution of mathematical equation. After we get the result from that solution, we stop. Because that is mathematics. That is only theoretical. But we are transitioning to the real world. How can we use that solution in our real situation? Okay? So we have to use that solution into reality to realize whatever design or construction or maintenance problem that we have. Okay? So this is the fourth one, is really the difference between engineering and mathematics. In mathematics, we don't have this fourth step. Okay? Okay, we will use the solution in order to solve. That's why engineers are what? Solving humanity's problem. Okay? For the comfort of human beings. Okay? For example, cars. That is for the comfort of human being. For example, engineers produce air conditioning. That is for the comfort of humankind. Okay? So that is an environment problem, but we are doing it as an engineer to solve the mankind's problem. No? Okay. It's not just the words. It's not solving it in essay form or in English or in language. Engineers have product. For example, cell phone. That is a product of engineering mind. Okay. Okay. So, using that solution in order to realize something. Okay. Hey, let us be clear about this. So that's why it is called solving an engineering problem, not solving a mathematics problem. Okay? Example of solving an engineering problem that is different from mathematics. Okay? Now, so you can see real world problem. So you can see in the picture, this is a real world problem. Okay? This is not a mathematics problem. This is an engineering problem. Okay. So this one related, we have a bridge. Okay. And bridge is a problem for engineering problem for civil engineers. No? Engineering problem for civil engineers, but usually if the bridge is static, okay? If the bridge are like this, which are what? Moving. this problem is mechanical engineering. Huh? Those structures that are not moving, that is the civil engineering. Huh? Those structures that are moving, those are mechanical. Huh? Mechanical engineering. So this type of movable bridge, the movable portion are the only mechanical part. The other part of the bridge, which are here, this portion and this portion are, of course, civil engineering. Particularly this, what? This column, these piers. Okay? Piers and columns are civil engineering. The moving part, particularly the joint here, are the mechanical. Okay? Part. Okay. However, all of these are engineering. Huh? So bridge. Okay. Bridge. So you can see this is you can see a roadway, but they are what? Making a bridge, so it is more like a sort of skyway or what above grade highway. So that is what we can see in this picture. Okay, that part on that portion here, that portion on the arrow, as you can see the black arrow here pointing in this specific part. You can see this one. This is the portion wherein we have a joint. This is a joint. Okay? Joint for what? For the bridge to be able to move, rotate. Okay? To be able to rotate. We have a joint here. Joint in this portion. No? So that it can rotate. Can rotate. Then some of the cars can able to travel, but if rotates goes up like this, cars will stop. But big ships can what? Can pass through. Big ships can pass through. So therefore, this bridge is actually obstructing the shipping lines. Okay, actually obstructing the shipping lines, but the shipping lines is not in use 100% of the time. There are a specific schedule that chips will pass through in these lines. So in other times, we can use what? We can use this bridge for transporting via land. Okay? So that's why we have what? Hub. Okay, we have hub, we have trunnion, we have what? Girder. So girder is another term for beam. It is a type of a beam. So just like if you are from TCO and you will go to SMB Kutan, you will walk on the what? Overpass. Okay, you will walk on the overpass from Bikutan to the SM building. You will encounter at the, almost at the middle of the overpass, you will encounter a girder. Okay, a very big girder. There are several of these. There are about 6 or 8 of these. There are big, almost you can almost touch it. You can almost touch it if you walk on the overpass. Okay, so and you will see this trunnion. Okay, this trunnion have so many what bolts. There are so many bolts in order to attach, in order to attach this trunnion to the girder. So attaching the trunnion to the hub, and the hub has so many bolts. Okay, you can even count the number of bolts because the picture is very clear. Okay, you can count the number of bolts here, and then this bolt attach the hub to the girder. Okay, so both sides, there are two sides, so one side and the other side. So the girder is the it's like this, the girder, and then there are trunnion attached to the girder, okay, like this, okay. So this attachment is necessary, okay. So like this, these are the parts, okay. Trunnion, hub, and then the plate that is going to be attached to the girder, okay. Trunnion, hub, and okay. So if it is assembled. So it is now in a symbol picture like this, okay? And in reality, like this, okay? Okay. Trunnion immersed in dry ice or alcohol. Okay, what do you mean by that? Why? So assembly, having an assembly of this is not an easy work. Okay, it is also an engineering procedure. So we have what? Trunnion, hub, girder, assembly procedure. Very simple matter, as you can see. But in reality, how to do it? Tremendous work, tremendous effort, tremendous engineering planning. Okay? Okay? So, step one, trunnion immersed in dry ice, alcohol. Why? Okay, we need this part to be what? Cool down so much. We need to cool it down so much compared to the ambient temperature. What is ambient temperature in our area? Our ambient temperature is about 30. Okay. In our area, here. Okay, so our ambient temperature is about 30 to 33, like that, no? And by using dry ice and alcohol, immersing this trunnion is the green portion, this one, the green one. So we have what? The green, the gray, and the blue-green. Okay, so there are three parts: green, trunnion, gray. This is hub, and the blue green is the girder. Okay, So we are talking of trunyon, so we are talking of green, this green one. So we have to immerse this green portion to very cold temperature. Why? Because we want trunyon to be cold, to cool down its temperature. Okay. So step number two, trunyon warm up in hub. Okay. So we will warm it up in hub. After this one, this is the step two. Put the trunyon, put this trunyon inside the hub. Okay. And then warm it up. Warm up in hub. Okay. So meaning of warming up, from cold temperature, we want to gradually increase, because the word is warming up, gradually, no? Gradually increase the temperature. Okay? Step three, trunyon hub immersed in dry ice and alcohol. So meaning to say, this assembly, this sub-assembly of hub and trunyon, again, immersed in cold temperature. Okay? Okay? Take note. Step one, trunyon, cold temperature. Then trunyon, warm up. Then step one, step two. What do you realize from your previous 2 years of engineering study? What do you realize in step one and step two? This is not my responsibility to review first year and second year subject. This is your responsibility, that every time you come up to class in this course, in this subject, you have to be prepared. Okay. What do you realize in step one and step two? You can recall that matters expand when heat is applied. Okay? Matters expand when it is applied. Therefore, I would like to call a name. Antonio, Buizon, and others. You are not turning on your video. Mangao, Abagan, you are not turning on your video. You will be marked absent if you are not turning on your video. Grande. Okay, I will call Antonio. Where did you learn that matter expand when heat is applied? Where? Antonio, are you there? Okay, maybe he is sleeping. Turn on your videos. Okay, I will call Butuna. Where did you learn that matters expand when heat is applied? Okay, another. So another roll call. So I am also calling you out your name so that I know who are absent and present. Okay. So I am recording. Vision. Vision, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Can you, do you have an idea of the question, about the question? I will repeat the question. Where did you learn that matters expand when heat is applied?
Sir, kapag ano po, sir, pwede po Tagalog?
Okay.
Sir, kapag yung isang bagay po, sinisikipan po, mas nage-expand po yung ano niya, yung, syempre po sir, nape-pressure po yung ano, yung pagsikip. Tapos, yung sa loob po nun, lumuluwag po.
Ah, okay. So, let us call the next one. Zacarias. Zacarias. Where did you learn? My question is, where did you learn that matters expand when heat is applied? Did you learn it from the wet market? Did you learn it from SM? Where did you learn it? So again, there's no presence, no? So presence, let's call another Galicia. Galicia. Okay, let's call Gweb. You have to answer immediately. I do not have time to waste waiting for you. Okay? If you don't answer immediately, I will assume you are not listening. Okay?
Sir, pwede pa ulit po ng tanong.
You don't know how many times I already repeated the question. I already repeated the question about 5 times. Okay. Who are you? What's your name?
Dexter po, sir. Gabe.
Oh, Gabe. Where did you find that matters expand? Where did you learn that matters expand when heat is applied? This is the 6th time.
Sir, P6 po.
P6. Okay. P6 in high school or in your first year?
First year college, sir.
Okay. Honyo? Nothing? It's not around? So, Rintotar? Are you around?
Yes, sir.
Okay. What is your answer?
From science, sir.
From?
Science.
From science. In STEM? Yes, or in first year engineering?
First year engineering, sir.
Okay. Okay, so some of you know that it is a science learning. Okay? So in science, you learn that matters expand when heat is applied. And let's go to the reverse. Heat is applied when heat is taken off. Instead of applying heat, we take off the heat. We take off the heat by what? Cooling it. Okay, so what will happen? What will happen now? So when heat is applied, the object will what? Expand, diba? Okay. matters expand when heat is applied. That is what we learn. What will happen to the matter if we take off the heat? Okay, let us again ask our student. Okay, so Montes. Okay, Montes. You're not listening. Tabes.
Yes, Sir Montes po.
Montes. You have to respond immediately. What? What is your answer?
Based on my experience, because here in my house, we experience that the door, when the season is cold, and the door become more easily to lock than when the season is warm season. The door is harder to lock. That's why I come up with my experience with that. With that question, sir.
Okay, so locking and unlocking the door.
Yes, sir. Because when warm season. It expands the door. That's why it's hard to lock the door. And when it's cold, then the material that used in the door become did not expand the door. That's why it is easily to lock the door. So.
Okay, so meaning if we take off the heat from the material. So the material will shrink rather than expand, okay? So it will shrink, okay? So if the material shrink, physically it will become smaller, no? Physically it will become smaller. So if the material become smaller, it could be easily fit into the hole. For example, look at this green portion here. This is trunnion. It could easily be put inside the hole of the hub because the trunnion is first immersed in dry ice. Okay. Then after the trunnion fit inside the hub, step two, the trunnion is warmed up while inside the hub. So what will happen? It will what? It will, the trunnion is warm up, not the hub. Okay? The hub's temperature stays at ease, but the trunnion's temperature is gradually increased. So the trunnion will expand. So therefore, it will, what? It will exert more pressure on the hub's hole. Okay? So, it will touch the hub surface with increased pressure because it is warm up. Okay? So, in step three, after step three, trunnion in hub. Assembly, disassembly, this one, as you can see, this one, okay? Disassembly are immersed in cold temperature, okay? So after immersing all of this material they have in the trunnion, at the same time, will shrink. They will shrink, right? They will shrink, okay? After this ring, then Step 4. Okay, step 4, Tronyon have warm up into girder. So, this assembly is put inside the girder and then warm up. So, it will again could be easily put inside while the Tronyon hub assembly is cold, but after it is put inside this hole of the girder, it is warm up, therefore it will again fit completely with greater pressure. Okay, if it is fitted with greater pressure, it means that it cannot be easily disassembled. It cannot be easily disassembled because the pressure is greater. If there is no pressure at all, it could easily be disassembled. Okay? So that is the reason why temperature manipulation in this assembly procedure is very important. Okay? So there must be somewhat engineering procedure. Okay? So basic concept, but it is very hard to do in actual. Okay? Okay? Very hard to do. You need so much dry ice and alcohol inside the particular bucket, big bucket. Okay? And you need what? Tools and equipment to do the putting in and getting up of the material from the bucket. Okay? So there are so many things that have to be prepared in this simple procedure. Okay, for example, after cooling, the Tronyon got stuck in hub. Okay. So, this is the Tronyon, the green portion. Hub is the gray portion. So, in the picture here, this is the Tronyon. This is the hub. Okay? Okay? So, after cooling, the Tronyon got stuck in the hub. Okay? Stuck up. So, that is not the purpose of Tronyon. We need pressure. We need the Tronyon to be fitted nicely inside the hub, but it should not stack up inside the hub because we need this Tronyon to rotate. Okay, take note. Can you recall an electrician plies? Okay, there is a Tronyon in hub configuration in plies, and you will notice there are no bolts that holds the plies together. Okay, the plies are being held together by Tronyon. Okay, that was fitted nicely and precisely at precise amount of clearance. Okay, precise amount of clearance, because if the clearance is too small, we will get stuck up. We will like this, stuck up. If the clearance is too big, we can easily disassemble the the plies. So I have a plies here. I will get the plies. Okay. Okay. I have a plies here. Okay. I have a plies. This portion is a Tronyon. We want the Tronyon to be able to rotate. Okay, so like this. It can close it can open. We want the trunnion to be able to rotate. So, we want the trunnion to have a specific amount of clearance with pressure, meaning it cannot be easily disassembled. You cannot easily disassemble this. Okay? You cannot take this out from one another. This is a trunnion configuration, a trunnion assembly. But we don't want this to get stuck up either. So the amount of clearance is so precise and accurate that an error is critical. So this is an engineering problem. This is an engineering problem. Okay? There is no screw. There is no, only trunnion that holds together, that holds the pair of what do we call this? Teeth? That holds a pair of teeth of the plies. The trunnion holds without additional screw. Okay? So the same is true with this configuration. Okay? Same is true. Okay? The question is, why did it get stuck? Magnitude of contraction needed in the trunnion was 0.015 inches or more. Okay. A specific amount. I know this because I am a machinist in Japan. I studied machining, precision engineering in Japan. I know this. We can do this. But we must be very precise. We are trained to do this, but we have to be very precise here. Okay? Did it contract enough? Okay, contract. Contract meaning shrink. Okay? Contract is an opposite of expansion. Okay? Contract expand. Okay? That is an opposite. No? Did it contract enough? Okay? So because if there is the design contraction and you did not meet the design contraction like this, it is very hard to open and close it. Okay? Very hard. Now it is very hard because it is what? It is old. And because it is old, there are what? Introduction of perchloride. Peroxide in our local dialect, that is kalawang. Okay? Because of the introduction of peroxide, it is now very hard to open and close. But initially, when this is new, it is very useful. It's very useful because there is a design clearance between the trunnion and the hub. Okay? So the question is, we use a certain amount of temperature in order to contract the trunnion, but did it contract enough? This is not a guessing game. This is not trial and error. Take note. We have to compute this in our engineering. We have to compute and calculate this temperature. We have an equation. Okay? What is the delta D? This is the diameter, change in diameter. Delta D is equal to original diameter times temperature coefficient times change in temperature. So this is an acceptable scientific equation in first year and second year. Okay, let us use this physics equation. Okay, diameter, we have 12.363 inches. So we have what? So we are using English units here because that is usually used in our textbook, which is from American authors. American authors, they are using English units, inches, Fahrenheit. But you can what? You already know how to convert. So that is not my problem. So you already know how to convert one system of units to another. That is your job to use it. Use your knowledge. Okay. We have temperature coefficient alpha equivalent to this value, and we have change in temperature. Okay. Negative 108 minus negative 80 is equal to negative 188 degree Fahrenheit. Change in temperature. Negative meaning we cool it down. We cool it down. Okay. So after computation, we have what? Negative 0.01504 inches. Okay, take note. I will go back to previous slide. Okay, you will notice here. Okay, the dimension needed is 0.015 inches or more. Okay. Okay. We have the answer. 0.01504 inches. Are we okay? Is this value satisfied? This value satisfied the condition of the problem here? Here, this is the condition. The magnitude of contraction needed was 0.015. Does our computation satisfy this condition? Okay.
Yes.
Let me ask the question to the next in line. Tindido. Tindido, are you here?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Can you answer my question? Can you answer the question?
The answer is yes, sir.
Yes. Okay. So you said yes. And what about Manggao? Manggao, are you here? Manggao. So I am, everybody just get out of the room. So I am alone. So maybe I can take off my mask. So Manggao is not here. Let's call on Kapulong. Kapulong.
Sir. Ano sir? Sir, affected po ba ng ano niya po ng sign po yung value po or hindi po? Kasi po pag hindi po affected nung sign po, yes po, na ano po siya, na-meet niya po yung diameter po na kailangan po kasi sinabi po doon 0.015 or more po, more than 0.015 po yung answer po natin.
Okay, so okay, therefore, let us ask Narvarte. Narvarte, are you here? Let us throw that question to Narvarte. Absent. Pedregal. Pedregal, are you here? Pedregal.
Ano po, sir? Tingin ko po hindi po na-meet kasi dahil nga po dun sa negative sign.
So you are saying that because of the negative, it is not, the result did not satisfy. Okay. De La Cruz.
Yes, sir. I am satisfied that limit because the minimum is 0.015, but the answer here is negative 0.0150, sir. Because the initial is only 0.015 more. So my answer is yes, sir.
You also said that it satisfied. Okay. Next.
Yes.
Rodrigo. Rodrigo, are you here?
Yes, sir.
Okay. What is your answer?
Answer no, because of the negative sign, sir.
Okay, so you are having the same answer as De La Cruz. Okay, so no. Both of you says no because of the negative. And Kapulong is having an answer which is depending upon the meaning of negative. Okay, so my next question is, because most of your answer are related to having negative or positive, okay, let me ask you, what do we mean by negative here? What do we mean by negative? Let us call on Ruiz. Ruiz, are you here? What do you mean by negative?
Tension po, sir.
Tension? Tension? Come again?
Yes, tension po.
Tension. Okay, so next, let us hear from Grande. Grande, are you here? Grande. Okay, so Vergara.
Tension din po, sir.
Tension. Because you know that Ruiz is bright, so you are just having the same answer. Okay. Try to analyze it on your own. So, if Ruiz jump up the hill, will you jump yourself too up the hill? So you have to think on your own. Okay. This negative here is not tension. It is nothing to do with tension. Look at the formula. We have the formula. Okay. We have the formula above here. Oh. Which I explained. I explained the formula. Change in diameter is equal to diameter times coefficient of temperature times change in temperature. So the result is what? Diameter or change in diameter. Okay. And the meaning of negative is diameter shrink, diameter contracts. That is the meaning of negative. Okay. It becomes smaller. That is the meaning of the negative sign. So, try to use all the powers of your 2 years of engineering learning. Okay? Because I am not here to review previous subjects. Okay? I am not here to review previous subject. I am responsible for this subject. Okay? So, I already gave you the formula, but still, you don't have any idea what is negative sign all about. Okay? Take note, huh? Take note. I am encouraging you to make an advanced study. Okay? Advanced study, at the same time, review previous subject. Review previous subject, advanced study, review previous subject, and practice, you know. Because this subject is going to be different. Going to be different. Okay. I'm telling you now. Okay. That is the only meaning of negative here. It is self-explanatory again. Oh. Magnitude of contraction. So, what do we mean by positive 0.015 here? 0.015 here is the magnitude of contraction, meaning the amount wherein the size shrink. So the size becomes smaller because of the word contraction. Okay? Needed to shrink. This is the magnitude wherein the trunnion need to shrink. Okay? Very self-explanatory from this sentence. Magnitude of contraction. Okay? So 0.015 is the amount wherein the trunnion shrink or the trunnion become smaller by 0.015. Very clear. Okay? Clear. Very small question, simple question, basic question, but nobody was able to point out. Okay? Nobody was able to answer it correctly. Okay? Okay. We have a formula and we are already through with calculus. Take note. You are already what? I can say that you are you already passed calculus. You have the minimum knowledge of calculus. Okay? Simple formula. AD is equal to delta D is equal to D times now. Okay? And then we have negative. What do we mean? Meaning the dimension, the diameter decreased because it is negative. Okay? Do we need calculus to be able to interpret this? No. This interpretation needs arithmetic or algebra. Algebra. Okay? So I would encourage you to review your algebra. If I said algebra, I am talking of how much can you express algebra into use, no? Using the algebra, not just memorizing the algebra. Okay? When you are already graduate of algebra or calculus, you are expected to, that is why we have the philosophy, okay? Okay? That's why we, the teachers, are asking feedback in order for us to be able to gauge what is your level of understanding. Okay? Of course, this satisfies because we are both looking at the numbers which are both meaning contraction. The negative here means contraction. The requirement is contraction. So, we are both given a contraction values, and this is 0.01504, which is greater than 0.15. So this satisfies the requirement, right? Now, the same. So when we have this formula, we need to what? To tabulate in order for us to be able to draw the curve. Okay. So using this tabulated numerical data, so we have these points. We can what? We can connect. We can connect the points, and we have what? A drawing of a curve. What is that curve? That curve is this equation, or this equation here. This is the equation of the curve, okay? Equation of the curve, which is the, okay, I will, again, ask the question. Okay, I will again ask question from above, Montes. Okay, in the graph,
yes, Montes. Sir.
In the graph, which one is the independent variable? Look at the graph. Which one is the independent variable?
I think, sir, temperature, sir.
Temperature. Very good. So, at least I know that you have knowledge of certain algebraic theory, like algebraic principle. Okay? So, let us call. So, Vergara. Upset. Butuna. Upset. Oh, Butuna. Can you tell us which one is the dependent variable? Which one is the dependent variable from the graph? Okay, please go back to your review of algebra. Cantor, because so, I will not wait. Cantor, which one is the dependent variable?
Yes, sir, the dependent variable, sir, is the temperature coefficient, wherein it is dependent to the temperature itself.
Very good. So I am testing your knowledge, because those knowledge are necessary for this understanding. For understanding of this, we have tabulated values and we have a curve. Okay. So here, again, let us call on Galicia. Galicia, are you here? Okay, my question, Galicia, is you already heard that we have dependent and independent variable. What can you say about the relationship? Looking at the graph, what is the relationship of dependent and independent variable? Please tell us the relationship. Okay. So please review your algebra because we don't need to memorize or pass the algebra. We need to know how to use, and we will use it now. Okay. Gweb. Gweb.
Yes, sir.
What is the relationship of the variables?
Sir, yung ano po, yung coefficient temperature po is parang bumibase po siya dun sa temperature na given po.
Okay, pakilakasan ng kote.
Yung coefficient temperature po, sir, bumibase po siya dun sa temperature na given.
Bumibase. Ano nga ang klaseng pagbibase? We are asking the relationship. Okay. I will give you a hint. If I have a neighbor which is a family of, for example, five, mother, father, and children. So there are three children and there are two parents, okay? My neighbor. And if somebody said that these neighbors are my relatives, okay? If I asked you, and after, what is the relationship to me of this one? It is my relative. What is the relationship? 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 My relative. What I am asking really is what type of relative? Is it my cousin? It is my nephew? Okay? We are engineering. We need to be detailed. Not just say, that is based on something. Temperature is based on coefficient. What type of relationship? Is that my grandfather? Is that my what? Is that my uncle? Be very specific. I am asking you
the relationship. Sir.
What is the relationship of the variables?
Family relative, sir. Based on your example, sir.
Okay. So, family relative. How can I distinguish one from another?
Sir, 1:1 relationship po.
I am asking how can I distinguish one from the other? I am asking who is that? Gweb? I do not expect that you to answer like that. What type of answer is that? I am asking you, what type of relationship I have to this one, to this particular one? Ah, sir, I know, it is family relative. What about this one? I also, sir, family relative. Hey, what about this one?
Sir, based on how sa table po, sir, 1:1 sila, sir. Sir, based on po sa table, sir, na nakalagay po dyan sa, ano po, sa presentation po, ano po, 1:1 po sila, sir.
Okay, so we need to review algebra. We need to review algebra, okay? Particularly you need to review algebra. Okay, But don't be discouraged about that. Okay? You have to even make up for the lost time. So maybe you have to minimize your what? Doing other things like playing games, right? So maybe you have to put more effort, more time on. So everybody does that. Everybody does that. If you want to become an engineer, you have to do it. You have to do it. Everybody does that. Okay. So
sir, sa pulong ko.
And that's why you know guys, it is not a simple matter to pass the subject, particularly in engineering, because you are expected to know that. If you pass the subject, you are expected to know that. Okay. It is a very different animal in college compared to high school. Okay? Very different. Okay? Okay? Because what we are learning in high school are basic education. Here, we are learning your future career, your potential career in the future. Okay? And there are nobody who are forcing you to do it. You choose to be in the program. You choose to be in the engineering program. So you have to have the time, energy, and effort to do it. Okay. So there are two raising hand. Okay, Kapulo, what can you say about that?
Ano po, they are directly proportional to each other po, because while temperature increases, while the temperature increases, the coefficient temperature also increases po.
Okay, so coefficient of temperature, it also increases. Okay, so there is some sort of proportionality, which is direct. Okay, direct. That is the type of relationship, direct relationship, directly proportional. Okay, directly proportional, as we say it in mathematics. No? Or if the graph is reverse, we can say inverse, okay? Inverse proportional, okay? Inversely proportional, okay? As simple as this, would not give you the potential to be an engineer? You need to double time. I am encouraging you to study right away, right now. Start right now. Okay, start right now. If you ask me, on our time, where did we started to seriously study engineering? On the very first day of engineering, first year, first day. That is the starting point that we studied seriously engineering. Okay. So since you are in the third year, you have to double time. You have to double time. Okay. So some sort of directly proportion, but it's not perfect. Okay, as you can see, it's not perfect. Directly proportional, perfect in its perfect sense, is actually a straight line. If you say directly proportional, if we are talking about mathematics, that is a straight line. However, we are actually talking of engineering here. We are transitioning from mathematics to engineering. So we can say in engineering, I will please listen. So from this two points, okay, the first two points, we have this straight line. And from the next two points, this one, we have again another straight line. And again, another two pair of points here, another straight line. And another pair of points, another straight line. Meaning, there are several straight lines. What we learn in direct proportion, in mathematics sense, if we have direct proportion, we have one straight line. Okay? But now, we have so many straight lines which have different slopes. We have different slopes. Okay? Here. So, what can we concur? What can we conclude about that? What can we conclude? Okay, let us continue. The correct model would account for varying thermal expansion coefficient. Okay, what is the varying? Take a look at the equation here. And take a look at the previous equation here. Okay? Delta D is equal to D. Alpha delta T. Take a look. Delta D is equal to D. Integral of alpha dt. Okay. What do we mean by that? It means, again, that we do not have a perfect relationship. We do not have a perfect relationship. The relationship is always directly proportional, but the amount of proportion is changing. The slope is changing. And this amount, the integral, is therefore cannot be calculated on a simple formula like the one previously shown. It is more difficult formula because the area, the definition of integral is area under the curve. The area under the curve cannot be solved by a very simple multiplication like shown here. Multiplying diameter to alpha to delta T. Okay? Give me time to plug my laptop to power supply. Okay, so what can you say about okay. So that is the difference. So we can have an exact formula. This integral is an exact solution. exact solution, but it takes into account, it takes into account that the thermal coefficient, the temperature coefficient, or the coefficient of temperature is varying, it is changing. It is changing its relationship with temperature. Okay? Okay? Changing it, what? Slope. As I show you. Okay? So, sundin nyo. Can you roughly estimate the contraction? Therefore, can you now do it? Okay? So, yes, we can. Because we know integral calculus. But wait. In integral calculus, we have to know the equation of the curve. The equation of the curve must be expressed in terms of temperature while we are finding out the dependent variable. Okay? Which is what? Alpha. Okay? We need to have an equation alpha in terms of temperature. In this graph, how can we do it? We cannot. We cannot because we are just given number of points. We are given how many points? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There are 8 points. Okay? But it is okay because we are looking at engineering solution, not exact. Okay? Not exact solution. Okay? We can therefore what? We can therefore solve this. Oh, if we are going to solve the integral of this, we are going to solve the area under the curve. And we can do it by connecting points, 2 points at a time, and then solving the trapezoid. Solve the trapezoid under any pair of points. And solving from the left side, going to the right, and we can get the total, sum up. If you get the total, that is the same as making an integral. Okay? So therefore, we can do it. Okay? We can do it. Okay, let us continue. Can you find a better estimate for the contraction? But although we can do it, the question is your estimate better than my estimate? This will now go to the skill of engineers. They are all engineers, but they have different skill. They can estimate better than the other. Okay. So not all engineers will have the same estimate. Because you know the given is like this. Okay? Real life problem. If the question is exact and the solution is exact, all of the engineers will be able to solve it the same answer with the same answer. Because that is not extreme, that is not estimate. That is the exact solution. But if you say you are asking an estimate, so one engineer is better than the other. One's estimate is nearer to the correct answer than the other. Okay? So, how can we do it better? Oh, the same formula, integral calculus, and we have the same curve. How can you do it better? Okay. Estimating contraction accurately. Change in diameter by cooling. The same. So we have the temperature and initial temperature, final temperature. Take note. Initial temperature is positive, meaning it is hotter. Negative temperature means it is cooler. Okay? The diameter is 12.3 So greater than 1 foot, because 1 foot is 12 inches, no? So 12.363 inches. Okay? So alpha is given by this equation. So what is this equation? What type of equation is this? Alpha. Okay, let us ask. Let us ask Manggau. Arir. Okay. Absent. Katubig. Are you here?
Sorry, Katubig present.
Katubig. What type of equation is this? Turn on all your videos. Those who have videos turned off are absent. I need to see your eyes. So, I am asking Ms. Katubig, what type of equation is this? What type of equation? Recall your algebra. Sorry. Recall your algebra. What type of equation is this? You don't know. Kunsalan, are you here?
Or factoring, sir?
So, those of you, please review, study algebra. Okay? I am asking very fundamental questions. I'm not asking you the questions that I would ask in our quiz. Take note, if I ask you the quiz type of question or the final exam type of question, you have to be prepared. I am telling you right now to please prepare. Don't be discouraged. Make this as a challenge. Challenge yourself. Challenge yourself. Okay. You cannot answer anything in this course if you don't review mathematics. You have to be prepared. First year, second year, mathematics, all of them, you have to review. Including science. Okay. So De La Cruz, what type of equation is this? I am just asking you, what type of equation is this?
Sir.
What type of equation is this?
Sir, di ko ganong lilig, sir.
Why? Which is the part you did not understand? I am just asking your question. What type of equation is this? This one. Which part you did not understand? How can I help you? More of you have to review algebra and pre-calculus subject and calculus subject. We need those. I am not joking. We need those subjects. I will show you later. In 10 minutes, I will show you why you need to review. I am not joking. You have to be prepared. Okay? do not expect to pass this subject without knowing anything. Okay? If you pass engineering subject, you are expected to know something, minimum. Minimum meaning, not one thing. Minimum is, minimum passing is 75% of the knowledge you should know. That is the minimum. Okay? I will teach you 100%. 75% of what I will teach you, you should know. Okay? And if I think that you don't have the 75% of what I teach you, then do not expect that you will pass the subject. Do not expect. Okay? You should have a minimum knowledge of this. Why? Because this is a fundamental, this is the starting point of engineering. We are transitioning from mathematics to engineering. How can you go further in engineering if you don't know this first step? This is the first step. Okay? So, I am not joking. I am challenging you. I'm challenging you right now. Roleo.
Sir, ano po? Quadratic equation po, sir.
Quadratic equation. Very good. Oh, that is a simple question. Huh? But most of you do not know that is it. It is a quadratic equation. You can see here very clearly. This is a quadratic equation. And actually, this is a type of algebraic equation. This is algebraic equation. Quadratic equation are algebraic equation. Cubic equation are algebraic equation. Quartic equation are algebraic equation. Okay? So why many of you do not understand? Okay? I am not joking around. You have to be serious about this. You will pass this course on your own merit. Okay? If you know 75% of the course, that is the minimum. 75% passing. 75, grade of 75. Okay? Hey, that's very good answer. Okay? So, I will immediately be able to recall that name. That is Mark Roleo. Okay? Okay? In order for me to remember your name, please challenge yourself. Okay? Salma Alipa. Salma Alipa. Where are you? You are not turning up your, you are turning up your video. You are upset. You have to turn on your video to get an attendance. Grande. Grande, where are you? You are turning up your video. I need to see your eyes. I'm absent. Next, Ruiz. Ruiz.
Sir.
Ruiz. So, I discussed with Rolejo that this is a type of algebraic equation. Can you give me another example of types of equation that are not algebraic that you learned in engineering? What are the other types of equation that you learned in engineering that are not algebraic?
Not algebraic po, sir.
What other type of equation that you learned in engineering that are not algebraic?
I do recall lang po, sir, the algebraic, which is the linear, which is the quadratic and cubic. But I can't recall something like not algebraic equation.
Okay. Okay. But not okay, I will call somebody. Oh, somebody's raising his hands. Montes, can you give us an example of an equation not algebraic which you learned in engineering? Oh, I thought you are raising your hand. You are raising your hand. You are raising your hand. Huh. You are not listening, but you are raising your hand.
Sir, sorry, naka-mute. Sir. Hello po, narinig niyo po ako, sir? Sorry po, naka-mute. Yung mga ano po, mga not algebraic expression, like ano, sir, like yung mga indefinite terms and ano pa ba? Indefinite terms and yung mga basta-basta. Like yung mga ano, sir, mga whole number, then coefficient. Basta not related, sir, sa variable, that is not algebraic expression, sir.
I am asking equation.
Equation, sir.
Okay. So clearly you don't know the answer. Okay. You don't know the answer. Okay. So, Eliza.
Sir, aside from ano po, algebraic equation, I remember some trigonometric equations, sir, which are the ano po, equation of line, general equation of line, and the standard equation of the line, equation of circle, parabola, and ellipse, and then.
Okay, you have an idea, but you go to the wrong direction. Okay, so you are going deeper and deeper into the wrong direction. Those ellipses are algebraic equations. All the conics equations are algebraic. Okay, but you said trigonometric equation are not algebraic. Okay, so clearly all of you studied trigonometric equation, but you don't know the answer that those are not algebraic. Okay, so very clear, all of you studied trigonometric. That's why not only studying, but understanding its use. Okay? Very different matter. You know trigonometry, but you cannot even define it. Okay? That is not an algebraic equation. They are belonging to what we call transcendental equation. Transcendental. Okay? So, please, because, for example here, what is that? We can use we can use other mathematical equation, not algebraic, and still come up with a good model. That is what I am trying to say now. Not only algebraic equation can be able to model this curve. In this case, this curve is being modeled by quadratic equation. But I can use, for example, cosine function. I can use cosine function, for example. I can use sine function. Okay? Which are not algebraic, but still could be able to model this curve. Okay? Or part of this curve. Part of this curve. Okay? So, that's why I told you minutes ago that there will become different answer from engineer to engineer because we are estimating which engineer would be able to come up with a better solution, with a better estimate. Okay? Because of the tools that we learn. What are the tools? Those mathematics. Those are the tools. We are now going to use those tools in order to find out the value of change in diameter. By what? By use of integral. In this example, using integral. But if I am going to solve this, I would use another method which we will result in another answer because those are estimates. Okay? So, maybe I will use cosine function. Okay? Or sine function. Okay? Or maybe I will use the now numerical method. Maybe I will use numerical method. Okay? So, there are plenty of tools that we learn. Now we are going to use. Okay? We're going to use. And I am actually getting feedback from you. Okay? So again, don't stop at getting the passing grade. You have to show it. You have to show that you are really able to understand algebra, calculus. Those are the things that we need. That we need. Okay. Do not stop. I already passed that. I just forget everything. After you become a licensed engineer, you can forget everything. But you are just starting to learn engineering. You have to recall every mathematics principle and concept. So what is the solution to the problem? One solution is to immerse the trunnion in liquid nitrogen, which is a boiling point. Take note, mathematics with science, that is now going to be real engineering solution. So mixture of math and science. No? Okay. Negative 321 degree Fahrenheit as opposed to the dry ice alcohol temperature of negative 100 degree. Why? This is science. Because you know, you have an idea in science that the normal temperature of liquid nitrogen is better than the normal temperature of dry ice. Better in this sense, because we need lower and lower temperature. Because we need what? More and more contraction. We need more and more shrinkage of the part. Okay? So that is what we mean by this statement. So, we can go as far as what? Negative 0.0244. It satisfies because it is what? More than 0.015. inches. Okay? Revisiting steps to solution, solving the problem. Okay? Problem statement, Tronyon got stuck in the hub. So, stuck up. So, like our here, huh? It is now stuck up. Stuck up. Okay? What will you do here? If you are not engineer, you will just what? Put an oil. Put an oil here and then try to do it repeatedly. Repeatedly. And then oil, putting oil, some film of oil will go in between the clearance of the metal parts and then try to do it repeatedly like this. Move it like this so that the oil film will be able to help to unstuck the parts. Okay. So now, but if you are engineering and you are a company engineer which is what? Which is manufacturing pliers. Therefore, your solution is not for one piece of pliers. Your solution is for many pliers. So you will plan it, you will make it scientific because it will come up again. The problem will come up again later. Okay. In this current situation of the problem, the solution needs to be engineering because of the magnitude of the problem. The magnitude of the complicated type of problem with the consequent risk to lives and property because of the what? It will become a bridge. One mistake would what? Would possibly get so much fatality. Okay? For example, if your trunnion what? Malfunction while there are what? Buses of small kids, no? Then all of the kids will what? Will be injured or at worst die from it. So engineer's mistake will cause so much fatalities or injuries. Okay, one mistake. So that's why, because of the magnitude of the application, you have to do it engineering way. But even if you are engineer and you are encountering one piece, you will not do this engineering solution. You will just what? Put an oil and do the technician's job of reviving your plies. Okay? That is, one piece is not in the same magnitude as the current situation. Modeling, develop a new model. We have what? We have the equation. Solution, use trapezoidal rule. Yes. Trapezoidal rule. The trapezoidal rule, we already learned. However, we use trapezoidal rule in order to teach you calculus. But trapezoidal rule is actually a numerical type of solution. Okay? So this forms part of the transition. Okay? Actually, because we are explaining to you what is integral calculus, we use trapezoidal rule. Okay? Or letter B, one or B, no? So one or two, dapat, no? Solution one, trapezoidal rule. Number two, use regression and integration. Regression and integration are being taught in statistics. So you are already good in statistics. You already passed statistics. You already passed calculus. So therefore, you know these things. I am not responsible for you for reviewing this to you. You know this thing. Trapezoidal rule, regression, and integration. If we are talking of integration alone, that is calculus. But if we are talking of integration in conjunction with regression, that is statistic. Huh? So we are being taught by statistic this principle, which is not the type of solution that we encounter here. This is not regression. This is what using the exact solution, because we use calculus, integral calculus, and we use quadratic equation. This is exact solution. Okay. However, here we are pointing at solution just trapezoidal rule, because we are looking at estimate of the exact solution. Estimate is acceptable, okay? Particularly when we are talking of what here, delta diameter here, estimate is okay. Okay, so number four, implementation, cool the trunnion in liquid nitrogen. So instead of dry ice, because we know that liquid nitrogen's normal temperature is lower than dry ice. So we have to implement that with certain specific temperature range. Okay. So that is an introduction to numerical method. Why we need numerical solution. Okay. Still, we have to undergo mathematical procedure, but we are now transitioning to engineering. Because in reality, there are situations that exact solution is not really useful. Exact solution is not useful. It is even useful to do the numerical method or the estimate rather than the, do you know that most of our, tell me any engineer application, they are all numerical methods. About 5% are exact solution. 95% numerical. Okay. Particularly number one, civil engineering and mechanical engineering. More and more exact solution in electronics and electrical or computer, but still there are still application in their discipline that needs numerical solution. Even in computer science, they are being taught programming languages in order to program numerical methods. Okay, so let us take a look what I'm talking about. So we are through with introduction. So let us take a look sharply in more details. Okay, what are the procedures that we need to be prepared for now? Be prepared for this. Okay. Nonlinear equation. You are not taught nonlinear equation in first year and second year. You are only taught the basic ones and the algebraic, trigonometric, and geometric equation. Okay? Transcendental. Okay? You are taught linear equation. Okay? Now, we are going to study nonlinear equation. Those are the type of equations that are usually used in real life in practical application. What else? Differentiation. We need differentiation because okay. Why we need differentiation? because the slope is not constant. We already show you a while ago that the line is not straight. The line keep changing its slope. Therefore, we need differentiation. Next, simultaneous linear equation. What do we mean by this? There are not one, but many. Not two, not three, many linear equation. For example, when I showed you the picture of complicated structure, one piece of structure, one linear equation. How many pieces of structure are there? How many components? So there are simultaneous meaning. There are many linear equations that must be solved. And it is better for us to solve this simultaneously. That's why the term simultaneous linear equation, because our method that we will give to you can solve many equations at once. For example, we can solve, for example, 5 equations at one go. Okay? We are solving one equation at a time in calculus, one equation at a time in other mathematics, in lower mathematics. But here, we can solve this simultaneously at the same time. For example, 6 equations solved at once. And you will not be amazed by this. You will not be amazed. But if we have a building, for example, 35 floors building, hundreds of equations, for example, 100 equations, we will solve at once. But with the use of tools, because if we do it manually, we can, but it's very hard manually. It will take so much time. One of your classmates will already graduate from engineering. And still, we are solving. We are still solving. So it's not practical. It's not practical. Of course, we will use tools. Okay? Because we are at the magnitude of 100 equation. But 6 equation, 5 equation, you can do it manually. Okay? You can do it. I will show you in this course. Okay, next, curve fitting, interpolation, regression. What do you mean by this? We already show you. Most of this we already show you. We show you nonlinear equation. That curve is an example of a curve that can be represented by nonlinear equation. It is represented by simultaneous linear equation. If you represent one slope by one equation. So there are several equations. You can do it. And you use differentiation because the slope is not constant. Curve fitting, because you are choosing the type of mathematical model to use. Either it is a trigonometric model or algebraic model or other types of equation. Okay? Integration. We also show you integration in that example. We use what? Estimation of integral problem. Okay? Integral calculus problem. We estimated. Okay? Next, ordinary differential equation. We have yet to show you. We show you later on. Ordinary differential equation. Other advanced mathematical procedure. We have partial differential equation, optimization, fast Fourier transform. Okay. You need to be familiar about all of this. These are previous subjects, first year and second year subjects. Don't tell me, sir, I mastered, sir, all of the mathematics and science in first year, second year, but our teacher did not taught us this I don't care. I will not blame your teacher, but you have to be prepared still. Okay? You might not get the time being taught by your teacher this specific topic, but you still have the responsibility to know this because these are prerequisite. These are prerequisite topic. Okay? Prerequisite. You have to review this. Okay? Let us continue. Nonlinear equation, for example, this one. Okay? This is a type of nonlinear equation. Okay. Very clear that this is a nonlinear equation. I will ask another one. Okay. Miss Christine May. Are you here? Christine May. Christine May, are you here?
Yes, sir.
Okay. What type of equation is this? Can you see the equation? This is?
Nonlinear equation po.
Okay, nonlinear equation. Okay. Very good. Kitang-kita nonlinear equation. But in algebra, how do you call this? How do you call this in algebra? Be very specific because just like what I've said, do I need to tell you the same story? Just when you are asked a question in engineering, you have to be detailed because nonlinear equation, there are so many types of nonlinear equation. What type of nonlinear equation is this? Okay. All of our time was used to get feedback from you. Okay. I would like to again and again encourage you to review. Okay. View. Okay. Differentiation. What is the acceleration at a given? Okay. The acceleration is what? Okay. But you can see in this curve, there is no acceleration. It is velocity versus time. How can you show me the acceleration here? For example, if I asked you, how can you show me the acceleration when the curve is velocity versus time? Okay, Ruiz. Please.
Sir, to get the acceleration po, we have to differentiate the given volume po to get the acceleration. And then we can substitute the time is equals to 7 seconds to get the acceleration po, sir.
Okay. If we differentiate the volume, we will not be able to get the acceleration. Maybe we have to differentiate the velocity, okay? And not volume, okay? So volume is very different from velocity.
Okay? Velocity.
Okay, so be very specific. It is the same as taking the slope, sir. Taking the slope of the curve That is the acceleration. Okay? That is application of your derivatives. Okay? Simple as, sir, we can get acceleration from the curve, velocity versus time, by taking the derivative, because the derivative is the slope. Slope of that. That is application. That is already application. And still, nobody knows the application of derivative. Okay? Okay? Nobody knows the application of. Okay? So, understanding, memorizing, and able to apply it are very different things. Okay? Very different. Different. In this course, we will apply. In this course, we will apply the mathematics in order to transition to engineering. Without which, we cannot do anything. We cannot understand anything here. Okay? So, simultaneous linear equation. So, we have here simultaneous linear equation, and still, you are familiar with this in algebra. However, the difference is we will apply. Okay? We'll apply. Not only you have to recall to understand, you need to review application in order to understand the subject. You need to review. Okay. That's why we have the philosophy. Huh? We have the philosophy. Be truthful to yourself. If you don't know, you have to review. Again and again, repeatedly, until you learn. Okay? Interpolation. Okay. Be truthful to yourself. Do you know interpolation? Say yes or no. Say yes or no in our chat. Make your answer in our chat. Yes or no? Do you know interpolation? Okay. I would like to know the number so that I have an idea. Okay. Interpolation. Okay. So, interpolation is again not a topic of this course, but probably I will give an example later. Okay, give my example later, because I got so many no answer. I do not have yes answer. Okay, well, there are so many no answer. So, but still, it is your responsibility to study interpolation. I will give an example, but do not depend on the teacher. Take this as an example. If I, for example, depend all of my future dreams of being an engineer to my teacher, and one teacher out of, for example, 30 teachers, one teacher which is handling our, for example, important subject, did a bad job of giving out or of handling the lecture, or for example, due to health reason, there are so many absences from the teacher. And that subject is very important. Okay? And I am depending on the teacher alone. Okay. Do you think I would become an engineer? Do you think I would become an engineer? Okay. So, a good teacher is a gift. A bad teacher doesn't matter. We still need to learn. Because it is what? We have a board exam to tackle. So, bad or good doesn't matter. We need to learn how. We need to do it on our own. You need to do it or not. Okay? So, better if the teacher is helping us. Okay? Better. So, do not submit an answer to, for example, PRC. Mr. PRC, don't ask me that question in the board exam because our teacher did not teach us that. So, it is not possible for the PRC to change its question just because your teacher did not have the time to teach you that particular topic. Okay? So, we still have to know. Okay? So, that way we are nearing the end of our discussion on the introduction. Okay. Regression. This is a regression which have to be familiar to you. Regression analysis is under statistics. Okay, you can open your book in a statistic and find out about regression. Okay. Regression is how can you find out the equation of the curve wherein there are only few given points. That is regression. Okay? That is curve fitting. Okay? So regression, so like this. You are modeling by regression, you are modeling this set of points by using mathematical straight line model. The blue line is a straight line, wherein the actual is not a straight line. The actual green dots are not straight, but you are modeling. Well, this is the difference of the word model. No, we are modeling it. The model is the one we are going to use, but we are given the actual points. Those are the green. No? Okay, so we are using the blue one, the blue line, in order to represent the green ones. Okay? Imagine the error. Imagine the error that will happen. Okay? Okay? Integration, finding out the contraction, like in our example, area under the curve. Okay? By estimate and by exact equation, exact solution. Ordinary differential equation, you will see it like this. In ordinary, you already know the differential equation. Okay? Already know differential equation. Ordinary differential equation is the first topic in differential equation. Actually, exact, no? Exact differential equation, then ordinary differential equation. Those are the basic topic in differential equation. How long does it take a trunnion to cool down? So in this equation, you will notice there is d theta dt. Right, d theta. Theta is the room temperature. Theta is the room temperature. It's given here. Theta room temperature. So dt. T here is time. Theta is temperature. So you can immediately analyze it by just knowing the forms. Forms of what? Of mathematical forms. So you really need not only mathematics, but also the form here is thermodynamics or science. Science, no? Science, physics. Physics 2. Physics for engineers, okay? So you don't have physics 2, so you have physics for engineers. No? So MC, DT, D. dt no? Equal to negative h a of t and then theta a. Theta a is ambient temperature. So actual temperature of the part minus ambient temperature. So the difference, this is how much we need the temperature to go down. so that we can have what? The necessary contraction that we need. Okay? We need the tronion, this part, to contract. How much? There is a requirement. The diameter should be 0.015 lesser diameter, okay, by 0.015 inches. Okay, so because of that, we can compute the temperature that is necessary for us to cool it down. So, and because this is a complicated equation, and we know that the coefficient of temperature is not constant. The coefficient of temperature is changing. That's why it is better to solve this not by exact solution, but numerical solution. So this simple equation could be solved by numerical solution. That is the end of our topic to introduce you. And that is only introduction. We have plenty of stories, but next week, next meeting, we will delve into the mathematics and engineering part of it. Computation, practice, solution. So you have to be prepared. This lecture is for you to be warned, to be challenged, to be prepared next week. Okay? Okay, so I already gave you what are the necessary things to be reviewed and do it this week so that next week you can have a good understanding of the lecture. Okay, any question? I got all the answer. No, not even one said yes. For the what? What is the topic? Interpolation. Interpolation is arithmetic. Interpolation is arithmetic. Arithmetic meaning high school. No, arithmetic meaning high school. No. So, I am not blaming your high school. I am not blaming your high school. Meaning, you have to be challenged, that you have to be prepared. It means that the topic is not complicated. It is high school type of topic. It's not complicated, but you still need to review. Okay, any question? You can have your question on the chat box if you want. Or you can have your actual question by turning on your mic, audio question, or later on, you can have your question by making a comment in this video. I will post this video for the benefit of those who are not here today or who are going to repeat and rewatch this video. So, you can do so. Okay. So if there are no questions, let us be warned, be challenged. I am challenging you because I want all of you to be engineers in the future. I will not challenge you if I don't want you to become engineer. I want you to become engineer, so I want you to be prepared. And be prepared, you have to do your job. Okay? You have to review, practice, and understand. Again, this is Dr. AP, your professor, preaching engineering for nation building.